Hey, how's it going, guys? Mr. Boss for the win here. And in today's Red Dead Redemption 2 video, we're going to be talking about Arthur Morgan's second love interest and how there was supposed to be a secret romance between two characters that are in the game, but that just never happened. We're going to be discussing all of those details in this video today. So let's start by talking about the one love romance that Arthur Morgan does have in Red Dead Redemption 2, and that is with a character named Mary Linton. Now, Mary and Arthur used to be in love before the actual timeline of Red Dead Redemption 2 begins. However, due to Arthur's outlaw nature and the fact that Mary's family didn't really like him, they eventually fell out of love. Mary ended up marrying someone else, and then she ended up becoming a widow. And that's when we see her contact Arthur in Chapter 2 to rescue Jamie from joining the Chelonian cult or whatever the case is. And you see Mary a couple other times throughout the course of the game, and that is the one love interest that Arthur has. Now, nothing ultimately comes about that, clearly based off of the ending of Arthur's story, but it turns out that he was supposed to have another love interest. And this isn't just random speculation. This comes directly from the creators of Red Dead Redemption 2, Rockstar Games, and the leader of Rockstar Games, Dan Houser, who actually had this quote in an interview. He said, "At one point, protagonist Arthur Morgan had two love interests, but in quotes, we decided one of them didn't work," says Dan. "And whole missions were removed because they were never going to work technically or be quite slick enough, or they felt superfluous. We removed a mission on a train where you had to deal with bounty hunters because it was fun at first, but then it wasn't. This part of the process is always about compromise and horse trading. Everyone always loses a bit of the game they love." So obviously the big point of that quote is that they had two love interests, but decided one of them didn't work. So we already know what the one that made it into the game was. That was with Mary Linton. However, there is a second one that we need to find out. And there's also a couple of key words in that quote as well. Superfluous, never going to work technically, or be quite slick enough. Those are all things we need to talk about. So let's talk about a potential list of candidates. And I saw a thread on the Red Dead Redemption mystery subreddit by a user, EmmaVly, who put together a really good thread that summarized a lot of the information I'll be discussing in today's video. So if you want to check out that thread for yourself, I'll leave a link to it in the description. So we're going to exclude Mary from this list because she's already confirmed. The first is Eliza. So Eliza is a waitress of Arthur's past who he actually had a one-night stand with. And Eliza is the mother of Arthur's son. And he would actually go back and visit them every couple of months. That's our first candidate. Our second candidate is Mary Beth, who is a 21-year-old member of the gang who has never been married and probably never been in a relationship before, and we know is a romantic daydreamer about love and ends up writing books in the epilogue. Our next is Sadie. Sadie, of course, is a married woman who'd been a widow for the time span of about 6 months and lives with the gang. And in the epilogue, about 8 years had gone by, and she indicates she's ready to move on. And the last candidate is Charlotte, who is a married woman who had given up because she has no idea about hunting and nature while living in the country, and she becomes a widow when Arthur meets her. Her husband, Cal, had actually died. So those are our candidates right there. So now that we have a list of potential suitors for Arthur's second love interest, I'm going to talk about now who I personally think it is, and that is Sadie Adler. And it makes sense for a lot of reasons. Let's talk about them right now. The first is that Arthur writes about Sadie in his journal a lot. Like, I mean a lot. In fact, there's a lot of interesting things he has to say. Like, for example, he stated, "If I ever get on her wrong side, I am a dead man. I don't intend to. She's a fine woman. Amusing and good-hearted and decent, angry." So basically from Arthur's personal journal, it sounds like he's attracted to Sadie, and he makes no mention of being attracted to anyone else besides Mary. Additionally, Sadie and Arthur tease each other a lot. You could almost kind of call it flirting in a way. You see this time and time again, and it really starts to begin in the beginning of Chapter 3 when they actually take a trip to Rhodes to get some supplies for Pearson to cook for the rest of the gang. Like, you start to see it a lot, like all the sort of interactions they have with each other. Now, in addition to that, they're both similar characters, and they went through the exact same thing. They both had tragic relationships in the past, and they both had their hearts broken. Arthur with Mary, and of course, Sadie Adler with her husband when the O'Driscolls killed him in the very first mission of the game. Additionally, just like Mary, Sadie is one of the few characters in game that you have the option to help or not help, and both missions will end with an open route if you do help, like Mary teasing that she still has feelings there for Arthur, and Sadie revealing what she thinks of Arthur. So both are very similar stories. So it's pretty clear that Sadie and Arthur both become closer than any gang member, sort of randomly out of the blue. But how could this be possible if content wasn't cut? And there's screenshots that Rockstar used to promote Red Dead Redemption 2 that adds to this story as well, where Arthur and Sadie can be seen riding together in missions that were never in the game. So it seems like a lot of the things that were cut out have to do with Arthur and Sadie. And speaking of riding together, Sadie will not ride with anyone other than Arthur. She makes this clear to John that she will ride with nobody. But this is a lie because she thoroughly enjoys riding with Arthur. In fact, she even asked in the Rhodes mission if he'll ride with her again. And she says, ha, if you can handle it. Which again goes back to the teasing, flirting nature that they have. Building off of that, Sadie also calls Arthur honey. I don't know about you guys, but I'm not calling every single person I meet honey if I really ever do. It would only be for someone that I think is kind of special. And I think that Arthur and Sadie both have a special relationship together. Another thing that's pretty telling to me is throughout the game, Sadie constantly tells Arthur that she and him are all that they need. And that theme of you and me pops up a lot, pairing the two together in a ton of different missions, whether it's the hot air balloon, whether it's breaking John out of prison. You start to see a lot of missions with them only doing things together. And as you get further on in the game, like those missions I just mentioned in Chapter 6, Sadie is really the only character, especially from the gang, that is concerned about Arthur's health. She asks him about it all the time and was actually taking care of him. In fact, she seems to be the only one that's really scared of losing him, which of course we know exactly what happens at the end of the game. And we're actually going to talk about this in a separate video because there is so much cut content from Red Dead Redemption 2, and it almost seems as if the original plan for the ending was to not have Arthur die. But because he does, clearly this would make a relationship with Sadie or anyone else really unfeasible. So let's talk about why it couldn't be the other girls that we mentioned on our list, Mary Beth, Charlotte, and Eliza. So Mary Beth, the big thing here is the age difference. She's 21. That seems a little young for Arthur, but then again, everyone has their own personal preference. But we know that she has fallen in like with Kieran, which is actually revealed by Chapter 4. And it also just doesn't seem like a great fit. Arthur is an outlaw. Mary Beth is a hopeless romantic. That doesn't seem like it would work all that well, in my opinion. Let's talk about the second one, Charlotte. So when you meet Charlotte, she had just ended up as a widow. She's desperate and hopeless because she has no way of surviving without Arthur. But you might actually think to yourself, well, wait a minute. She kisses Arthur on the cheek at the end of the game. Doesn't that mean there's some romance going on there? I saw that as more of like a kiss of thankfulness and grace, and there's no dialogue between them that really ever implies a romantic narrative. And there's a lot of things that would suggest this wouldn't work. Number one, Charlotte seems to be a lot older than Arthur by the epilogue. It seems like she's definitely like 10 or 15 years older. She's also a city girl. Arthur despises everything about the city. He's all about robbing rich folk. And Charlotte is just a regular city rich girl. And we know he suffers from PTSD due to Eliza. So would he get involved with someone like Charlotte just to potentially be hurt again? And she also lives north of Annisburg, which is really, really far away. So I think all those reasons right there indicate that that is a no-go. And the final one is Eliza. And the big thing with Eliza is she's dead and has been dead for at least a decade now. So how could a romantic narrative even be possible here when she's dead? And it sort of seems as if Eliza was just a one-night stand with Arthur. There wasn't any real indication that there was love or any connection going on there. So the only obvious answer here, unless it was a character that they completely wiped from the game, is Sadie Adler. She sort of checks all of the boxes. She lives the outlaw-style life, so Arthur would not have to hide any of his doings. In fact, she'd probably join along on a lot of those things. She seems to be the type of girl that Arthur is interested in, despises the city, is rough, is tough, everything like that. They also have developed a relationship together over years throughout the game, so it's not someone that's completely unknown to her. And evidence of this being the case where Sadie is Arthur's second lover is supported by glitches that can be found in game where she'll actually follow Arthur outside camp and follows him wherever he goes, which could potentially be leftover code from the game. You would assume this would happen maybe later on in the chapters or in a post-game scenario where Arthur and Sadie do have a relationship together, and there's almost sort of like a Skyrim-like companion aspect where they essentially just follow each other around, help each other out on missions. And that would be kind of cool. So I don't know about you guys, but it really does seem as if all signs are pointing to this second long-lost love interest to be Sadie Adler. And keep in mind, let's go back to the original quote that Rockstar actually put together. All of those things start to make sense. It would never have worked technically because at the end of the game, Arthur died. It wouldn't be slick enough because they're both gang members together, so someone would clearly figure out that they're in a relationship. And let's be honest, Red Dead Redemption 2 is a game about outlaws, so there's your superfluous. It might seem unnecessary for Arthur to have another love-romance relationship, which is something we haven't really seen a ton of in any Rockstar title, to be totally honest with you guys. So anyways, that is all the information that I got for you guys in this video today. I'm sorry this was a long video, but there was a lot to talk about here. I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments down below. Let me know what you think of this. Do you think all signs point to Sadie? Do you think all signs point to someone else like Mary Beth? Let me know your thoughts, opinions, and more in the comments down below. I'd love to hear from you guys down there. If you did go on to enjoy this video, though, a like rating would, of course, be awesome. And subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new or you like daily Red Dead Redemption 2 videos like this. With all the way, guys, like I said, thanks so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.